In this video, I'm going to walk you through how do you set up Facebook Business Manager step by step and what are the most common mistakes we see along the way. Join me. Business Manager is a fantastic tool to be able to set up access and control audiences between the different assets you have with pages and ad accounts and other kinds of assets. Why is Business Manager important? Custom audiences are the crown jewel of Facebook ads, the thing that produces the most revenue and results for us. And Facebook's made a rule saying that if you want to be able to use custom audiences, you have to use Business Manager. Now, a lot of people have complained about Business Manager saying it's too difficult and it's really hard. And when they switch to Business Manager, they have trouble switching back and they lose access. I've lost my page. But that's not actually what's occurring at all. Business Manager is where you're controlling access across your different assets. So when you move assets into Business Manager, all the access is being controlled over here, no longer personally being controlled. Your personal Facebook, that's completely separate than Business Manager. Now let's talk about what are some of the components inside Business Manager. So here from Business Manager, it allows me to manage my ad accounts, pages, and the access to those particular assets. Now they say ad accounts and pages as the two primary kinds of access, but you can also share partner access, you can share apps, you can share lines of business, you can share pixel data, you can share catalogs. There's a lot of stuff you can share, but for the basics, just know it's your ad account and it's your pages. Whether you are sharing with other people on your team or they're sharing that with you, they're gonna have to have their own business manager. So it's their business manager and your business manager sharing access together. If you don't have a business manager, go to business.facebook.com. Here, you're able to click on the blue button where it says create account and fill in all your particular details. All right, now that we're inside Facebook Business Manager, let's take a peek and let me show you how to be able to control access. I'm able to choose between the different business managers that I have access to. In this case, we have a lot of business managers because we're an agency. But if you're a client, you might have access to just one. Go inside that primary business manager. Now you can see we're inside the Blitz Metrics Business Manager and it's showing me here on the left how many pages I have, how many ad accounts, catalogs, apps, pixels, lines of business, and other things that I want to control access for. What are some of the problems that you're able to overcome when you have your business manager set up? One is you don't have rogue employees that are running away with your data or locking you out of your systems. Two, if you lose access to an ad account because it got banned or because something got deleted, you have recourse because you've got it grouped into a business manager and you have someone else who has admin to be able to rescue that for you. Three, the more data you have inside Business Manager, the better your performance is going to be. Facebook's system relies upon data, especially custom audiences, to drive conversions. Four, you can delegate out the operational day-to-day of maintaining access. Every time you have a new landing page, you have a new website, you have a new pixel, you have a new partner, you have new team members, all of that stuff you can push out and be managed by someone else or managed by another process instead of you having to share your logins or having to personally take care of the administration of those particular assets. Let me walk you through how you set up these different assets and then how you invite people to get access to them. Let's start with pages. I'm going to click on the blue button for add and I can either add a page that I already own or I can request access to a page that someone else has controlled. And then number three, create a new page. I don't really recommend creating pages from here. Warning, by the way, when people add their pages, the number one thing we hear them say is it disappeared and I lost access. No, you didn't. You still have access. You just have to enable it from your business manager. This is going to save you a ton of frustration knowing that you have to manage explicit access for who can see those particular assets. If I want to request access to someone else's page, I can put it in here and I've got a list of these different pages that I can then say I would like to request access to, right? And then I can request the level of access that I want, which will then create a prompt for someone who's an admin to say, oh, well, Dennis would like to have access to this particular asset and they can either approve it or deny it. Now, the same is going to be true of your ad account. When I click on the blue button to add an ad account, I can add an existing ad account that I already have control over, or I can request access to another ad account. And by the way, here's a big rule that we see a lot of people getting banned on. You need to have one ad account per page that you have. So if you have five different pages, you need five separate ad accounts. If you try to run one ad account for all of those clients, you have a high risk of getting banned and shut down. And when you're shut down, it's very hard to get that account back. Okay, let's talk about adding access. When you're inside the business settings on the left side under users, and people, I can navigate towards the particular person I want to manage their level of access. If I click on the button Add Assets, I can choose which pages I would like to give this user access and then what level of access I want them to have. So if I click on this particular page, I can see on the right side that these are all grayed out. I've got 5 different levels of general access: publishing content, moderating, creating ads, viewing page performance, manage jobs. By the way, most people are not managing jobs or managing earnings. The option at the very bottom, manage page, notice if I click that, all the other items turn blue. Because if you're admin, by default, you get everything that's lower than that. And I can choose one or multiple pages that I want to be able to give that level of access to, and then I click Save Change. Now notice here on the left, I'm initially managing access to the page. I can come to here below and say, here are the ad accounts. I choose the particular ad account, then I choose what level of access I want to that particular ad account. If I select admin, then all the other items become blue. But if I'm not able to check the admin, it means that the business manager doesn't have admin level access to grant. Try to get admin access wherever possible on those pages and ad accounts. You never know later where you run into a problem where you need to be able to add people and remove people. You can't do that unless you're an admin. So let's talk about how do you add a person. Under people here, click on the blue button for add. And in this case, I can enter the email address. Let's say there's another Dennis at blitzmetrics.com, and it'll send them a note saying, hey, you're being invited to a business manager. Now, when you assign someone to a business manager, notice I have a choice, employee access or admin access. Be careful not to add everyone as admin. Give someone admin only if they actually need it, because anyone who's admin can kick out everyone else, and that can be a problem later. I've seen this result in disasters, but make sure you have at least 2 admins, because in case one admin goes missing, you wanna be able to back it up and have someone else who can come in and take that over. You may wanna grant access to someone from another agency and not invite them as a user because they're not an employee and they're not an admin of your company. In that case, Facebook's created the partner level of access. So you can see partners right here under users, and under each partner that we have assets that we have shared and assets that they have shared with us. If you're assigning access to another agency or partner, anyone inside their business manager, they can grant access to. So be sure that you have some kind of signed contract and you trust whoever you're granting access to, because whatever level you've granted, they can grant to anybody inside their business manager. A lot of people are confused on how do you grant access to other people inside your company. So we've created this access checklist to simplify the headaches and avoid the most common mistakes. First off, you want to have your Facebook business manager as one of many kinds of access that you're granting, including your Google Analytics and your Twitter and your Quora and your Instagram and your email and other kinds of access. Now, Facebook is the one where people get the most confusion. And what they'll do is they'll add people to their personal Facebook account or give a login to their personal account, which you don't want to do. You should never, ever share usernames and passwords. You want to use Business Manager. All too often, we see agencies that have control over the Facebook ads account. If for some reason you want to stop the relationship with that agency, they're not able to get the ad account back. So you want to make sure that it's your ad account and it lives inside your business manager. Then you can start granting access to other employees, to other agencies which are under partner access. The same is true of Instagram. You want to make sure your Instagram business profiles are linked back to Facebook inside your business manager. When you link them together and you're running ads on Facebook, now you can run across all the placements, which include automatically across Instagram. This is going to generate an additional 20 to 30% more conversions for you. Now that you've set up your Facebook business manager, the next step is to set up your Facebook ads account. And I want to introduce you to my buddy, Rick Mulready, who's going to walk you through Facebook ads manager, how do you set up your campaigns, all the structures that continue from what you've just learned about setting up your Facebook business manager.